Good morning, everyone, and welcome to First Christian Church here in Independence, Kansas. Please join us as we celebrate our little angels during camp.
Welcome today to Camp Sunday. This is one of my favorite, LaDella and I's favorite times of the year, as we celebrate the gifts and blessings of Christian Church Camp. And what we try to do is to bring a little bit of that camp experience to you, the church congregants, and to you folks who are streaming and watching and viewing us online. We're so appreciative that you're here today. Now, let me give you a basic intro of what church camp is all about. It gives the little kids and all kids of all ages, up to teenagers, and a chance to experience God in a setting with other kids just like them, without their parents, being guided with a few counselors and with the love and word of God. And each day we go through basic agendas and basic curriculum to look at God and the perspective of how it will help those kids to know God better in their daily lives. For instance, the first day you might say, how to enjoy and find God each and every day in your life. And then you might grow to look at finding God in a restful situation, or in a peaceful situation, or an area where God can comfort you and hold you and be with you. Also, there might be times where God could be a gracious God, a helpful God, and a God of encouragement. And so we use those things from the scriptures, and each day we take a specific scripture verse, and then we use that as our theme throughout the day. And each day at church camp, we do an assortment of variety of activities. We meet in small groups to study and to look at the Word of God for that day. And then we also play a lot of games. We do a lot of team building and a lot of ways that we can work together to do community service, where we work at the campgrounds, or we'll go off-site and do a special community service for that community or for that town. We also do a lot of other gameplay activities, swimming, and a lot of extracurricular activities like that. And then, of course, we have a great cafeteria where they have great food for a lot of these kids and teenagers that normally don't get a very healthy meal each and every day. And we make sure that they do get a very good and healthy meal. But we thank you for joining us today. And what we will do is go back and forth with some old clips, kind of show you what we've done in our church setting before with a Camp Sunday. Now, we know during 2020, because of the COVID epidemic and pandemic crisis that we've been suffering through as a nation this year, most church camps across the country were canceled, just like the church camps that we offer and go to. It was canceled this year. So this will be kind of a highlight of past church camp experiences and give you an idea how wonderful and how much a blessing and how meaningful it is for a lot of these children and a lot of these teenagers to have church camp as part of their life. And of course, songs are a big part of camp. Sing a lot of those great Christian songs like Jesus Loves Me and so forth. So here's a sample, some of the few songs that we like to sing at camp. And I hope you enjoy them.
Okay, yeah, we're ready.
He's gonna get fired up.
Okay, we're fired up, let's go.
Here we go.
You Lord, oh you Lord, oh do you remember me?
Oh
you Lord.
I
to worship today. He was a church camp. He was at a worship church camp.
Have y'all ever heard this song? How many of y'all have heard this? Okay, for all y'all that know it, please sing with me loud and clear. You ready?
Yeah, ready.
Come, now is the time to worship. Now is the time to give your heart. Come, just as you are to worship. Come, just as you are before our God. Come.
Amen.
One of the great blessings we do each year at church camp is we do a daily community prayer called God's Child. And it's where the kids kind of express from themselves and from their hearts about being God's child and how they're building to be a better child and adult for God. So enjoy listening to this special prayer, this special community prayer called God's Child.
So, Shereen, you'll start, then Tyler, then Lanella. We'll just go back and forth, okay? So we're going to go in again. Here we go.
I am.
Wait a minute. Say it again.
I am. God's child. I may be black.
I may be white.
I may be wrong. I may be right. But I am. God's child. I am. God's child.
I may be fat.
I may be thin.
I may be out.
I may be in.
But I am. God's child. I am.
God's child.
I may be tall.
I may be short.
I may be cool.
Or maybe a dork.
But I am.
God's child.
I am.
God's child.
When I am down.
He picks me up.
When I am thirsty. He fills my cup. For I am. God's child. I am. God's child.
When I am down. When I am sad.
When I am sad.
He cries with me. When I am happy. He laughs with glee. For I am. God's child.
I am.
God's child.
His heart.
Is my heart.
His face.
Is my face.
His spirit.
His spirit.
Is my spirit.
Is my spirit.
For I am. God's child. For I am. God's child.
Though I stumble.
And I have sinned. He picks me up. And invites me in. For I am. God's child. I am. God's child.
I am thankful.
For his love.
I am thankful. For his grace.
For his grace.
I am thankful. For this church.
For this church.
For I am. God's child. I am. God's child.
One more time, everybody. I am.
God's child.
You need to believe that, folks. I am.
God's child.
Let's say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father,
thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sinned against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is your kingdom, your power, and your glory forever and ever. Amen.
Okay, thank you all.
One of the activities that we do when we first come together on the first day of church is to kind of do a name building, a group activity where we get to know each other and work together with each other. And so today we're going to show you a video how we got some of our church members to come in to sort of play that activity. And you can see some of the fun that happens when we do this.
Okay, and you stand right here. We need one more over there. Okay. Is this going to work out? Well, Adele, you'll need to get in here. Oh, no, we don't. Okay, that's fine. Right here. And Jim, why don't you be over there next to Mary? Okay, this is called a name game, and we usually get in a circle. Okay, yeah, back up.
We want everybody to see Jim and see me fail.
That's right. Okay. This is called a name game. It's a way to kind of meet folks in the small groups. So what we ask them is we ask them to tell them their name, what they like about church, and then, what's their favorite mission? My name's Mark. I like church because we have such great fellowship and friendship with so many folks here. And my favorite vegetable is asparagus. And then I throw a ball to somebody, and you have to remember who you throw the ball to. So you say your name.
My name is Jim. I love coming to church for all the people and all the fellowship, just like Mark. And my favorite vegetable, I don't know if this qualifies, is tomato. Mm.
Is tomato a fruit or a vegetable?
Green beans.
Okay, Kate. All right. Okay, and what's your name?
I'm Nan.
What do you like church?
People, family, fellowship, and also the education.
Okay.
I like to learn.
What's your favorite vegetable?
Chocolate,
all right. We're gonna work on that now. Okay.
My name is Wanda. I like to come to church because I like all my friends here, and I like the peacefulness on Sunday morning. And my third vegetable is corn.
Hey.
My name's Mary, and I love broccoli, and I love everybody here, and I love to come to church.
Amen.
Throw the ball somebody had him.
My name's Wilma Andrews, and I love to come to church because I like to see all my friends here and learn as well. And my favorite vegetable is broccoli.
Okay. Is somebody in there? Okay.
My name is Carl. I like to come to church because put up with me just as I am, for the most part. Anyway, and my favorite vegetable is peas.
My name is Ladella Lyon. I come because of all of you, and because it's my time to praise the good Lord up above, which I try to do every day. And let's see, my favorite veggie would have to be cabbage.
Okay, so now this time, what we do is we got to go around and try to learn everybody's name. So I got to call the name out and go through the same order. Jim, and you got to call, who would you pass it to next?
Oh, yes.
I don't even remember who you passed. Who'd you pass it? You got to call her name out. Oh, Ned.
You
stole it from Ned. See, that happens all the time. Okay, now you need to call the person that you're throwing the ball to.
Juan.
Okay.
Mary.
Wilma.
Madel. You ride into the car.
Yes.
You're supposed to get in the car.
Too bad.
There's always a rebel at camp, and there's always a rebel. Okay, get the car.
Okay.
And then pass me. Mark. Okay, let's do it again a little faster. Jim.
Ned.
Wanda.
Mary. Wilma.
Okay, one more time here. Wait a minute. Okay, ready? Go. Jim. Ned. One. Jim. Ned. What?
Mary. I didn't hear what you said.
Oh, my God. Well, you gotta go the same way you're going. What are you doing?
On my car. Wilma.
We got one. Jim. Ned.
The same way.
Jim. Ned. See, it's trying to get some of the kids to obey and pay attention, you know. That's one of the first things we try to do at camp. Okay.
Okay, Ladella, let's talk about some of the experiences that we've been blessed to have during church camp. What's one of your fondest memories?
Probably one of my fondest memories would have to probably be the first year that I ever went to camp, which was 11 summers ago. I had never, ever been to camp, as I've told you all. Well, something that really stands out to me, I am so scared of spiders and snakes, which you know that. Well, the children, you know, and Mark and I, we were all sitting at a table. And I noticed a lot of children kept looking over at my glass, and of course they'd look at me, and the little children would start giggling and whispering, and Mark, you know, being him silly self, he was kind of making faces, you know, and we were eating lunch is what we were doing. And I was just, you know, I'd taken a couple of drinks and everything, and I didn't notice what was going on because I was, you know, enthralled with the children and listening to their stories and us getting acquainted and stuff, remember? Well, on that last sip of water, I look down and I see something dark. You know what it was? It was a black plastic spider. I about jumped, and all those children, oh my goodness, I don't know if we've ever got it. Did we ever record it or not?
No, but they loved it.
But it went on for the rest of the week.
So sort of like that spider you got down there?
Mark, now quit it. See what I mean? It's just those little things that can stand out. But I tell you what, I have learned through the years that you never, ever know what this guy's going to do.
I think one of the funnest things I really enjoy about camp is that coming together, because that first day we have so many individual kids that are kind of shy, though really probably a lot of them don't have a lot of friends at school,
right?
And they're all, we break down all those social and barriers, because everybody has to start wearing the same kind of clothing. We all do the same activities.
Yeah, it's like we come together.
Yeah, and by the end of the week, we're all unified under Christ.
Yeah.
And when they do so, by the end of the week, we're all crying because nobody wants to leave, because we realize we've had this special time together with God's blessing. And we encourage them as they go home to continue to be a blessing to their family, even though we know in a lot of cases they're going back home to a situation that's not a real positive situation.
Well, and another thing too, Mark, that I've noticed with my experiences with camp is just like you said, after you leave there, it's like God and those children are with you sometimes for months.
Forever.
Yeah, I mean for months. I can still go back and I can just kind of close my eyes and I can still see so many of those children each year that we've been with and watching them grow. And how their lives have been changed.
And you make lifetime friends at church camp. And a lot of kids can't wait till next year to be with their friends. Some of my friends today, I'm in my 60s, can you believe it? And I still am close to two or three friends that I met way back in my teens at church camp. And what we see, a lot of these kids too, once they graduate from high school, then they become counselor interns.
We've
come back
that.
And start working with us, counseling the next group of kids. And then in turn, they become counselors. And it just keeps repeating the process.
It's just wonderful. And for those of you that have never, ever gone to camp or been to camp, Mark and I, we can tell you, we encourage you to go, or at least send your little ones. It is a life-changing experience.
And one other thing I'd like to bring up is during our nightly worship at camp, one of the coolest and most blessed, just awesome type experiences is to experience worship at church camp. The reason is because the worship is done totally by the kids. Each small group takes a different part of the worship service. Like one night, say our group will do this, is responsible for this music. The next night, our group's responsible for the communion. The next night, our group's responsible for the message and so forth. And so each group participates, and we work together to, they work together to put forth this awesome worship. And it's so different from the kind of worships that we traditionally see each and every Sunday. They're so authentic. They're so real. They're so honest. And they're so emotional because it's coming from these kids' hearts and their own spirits. And it's a way for them to really reach out where they don't normally have a chance to. And so one of the things that a lot of us, a lot of you folks will miss if you're not a counselor at church camp is the fact that these little nightly worship services are just unique, special services that are totally run and totally formatted and done by the kids. And many times you walk away rejuvenized, your spirit's been lifted up, you've been really moved and touched by the love of God.
And I saw the light, no more in darkness, no more in that way. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw
the light. I'm sorry,
you'll notice we have these things at our camp called energizers. Usually right after we eat, they gather all the kids together and they play a couple songs where they've learned a lot of dance steps to kind of get them fired up for the afternoon and the morning as we get ready to do a lot of our activities. And so here's a sample of some of those energizers we do, and you get to watch LaDella kind of dance with the kids. It's a lot of fun.
Sweat, 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 sweat. Get your head on the wall. Ski, 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 ski,
I'm
About church camp today?
I found it as wonderful as I always do. Can I say that?
And we ask you, we want you to be touched by the love of God. Encourage your children, your grandchildren, any other friends that have children, encourage them to go to your church camp, your local church camp next summer. And I'm telling you, it'll make a huge difference on the lives of those childs, won't it?
Mark is absolutely right. You know, I remember the very first time I went, I thought, oh, I was so scared and kind of nervous too. You know, I'd never been to church camp. But honestly, I can say I'm tired. I'm worn out by the end of that week. And I always say, oh, I don't know if I can do this again. But I always find myself that next year, I get fired up on that first evening. I really do.
That's so right. It's a real blessing, and we ask you and encourage you to get fired up for God. And one of the best ways is to experience church camp. If not for your life, do it for your kids or your grandkids, and you'll see how God can change their life.
Beaver 1, Beaver 2, let's all be the Beaver Pope. Beaver 2, Beaver 3, let's all climb the Beaver Tree. Beaver 4, Beaver 5, let's all do the Beaver Jack. Beaver 6, Beaver 7, let's all fly to Beaver Heaven. Beaver 8, Beaver 9, stop! It's Beaver time!
Go Beaver! Go Beaver! Go Beaver! Go Beaver! Go Beaver! Go Beaver.